I'm back at the National Arboretum to help with the banding of DC-9. But Dan and I aren't the only ones watching.
The eagles, they're keeping a close eye on what's going on. I mean, that is their nest, that is their chick. You know, they're gonna be protective.
You can hear them.
Now they're starting to vocalize.
Wow.
Yeah.
I've never heard bald eagles make a sound before.
That is her first chick. So you can see why she's a little concerned.
Yeah.
This is Lotus's
first
baby.
That's her child. The parents are circling, and I gotta admit, I'm feeling a little anxious too. I just wish I could tell Mr. President and Lotus that this is for DC-9's own good.
Want to see Jim?
Oh, there's Jim.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
The chick now sees Jim. DC-9 is making himself look really big.
Yeah.
Kind of puffed up. Look at me, I'm a big eagle.
Don't mess with me.
Yeah, don't mess with me.
I don't think just buying it.
Once he gets into position, he's going to wait until that bird chills a bit.
So Jim likes to talk to his eagle chicks.
Oh.
You look healthy.
Parents' feathers.
Jim soothes DC-9 by speaking to it in low tones with a calm voice.
He's the eagle whisperer.
Yeah, say that the chick is perfectly calm.
All right, so now it looks like Jim is in the zen phase.
He looks like he's having a wonderful conversation.
Yeah.
He's facing him, he's got the feet out, wings are down. Look, they're talking.
The eagle is riveted. Jim is a great conversationalist.
Okay, you ready?
And then he's gonna put it in a bag, a bird safe bag.
He's got a bird safe bag right there in his, right around his waist.
Ooh. He's got the bird.
All right.
DC-9 is in the bag, literally and figuratively. As Jim makes his way down with DC-9, Dan and I prep the banding station. Jim, we slid into the shade here so that the bird is not stressed out from heat.
That's perfect.
Contrary to what many people think, our human smell won't spook DC-9's parents, and they'll be back by its side soon enough.
Okay, you ready to meet DC-9?
Oh, wow.
You're adorable. Let's see if we can get him or her to walk out of the bag. This is their first steps on the ground.
There you go.
Wow, hi. Hello there, DC-9.
This eaglet appears to be in really good condition. This panting is normal for a warm day like this. Stress levels are really low.
The idea that I am an arm's length away from a bald eaglet is something I never imagined would be happening, and it's unbelievably cool.
Okay, should we start?
Let's do it.
Okay.
Make no mistake, Jim and Dan are the real experts here, and they're doing the real work. I'm just trying not to freak out from excitement from cradling this baby bald eagle. I got you, little one. I got you. You're good.
That is it.
I can feel his or her breathing against my chest. It's an actually calm, soothing feeling. Now that the band is crimped in place, it's time to draw some blood and take some measurements to determine DC-9's sex. It's okay. You're good.
Small feather.
You're good.
It's most likely a boy.
We have ourselves a boy.
And that's it. Ready to go back in the nest.
All right. This bird has become an icon for Americans coast to coast. So that makes this family of birds a real focal point of attention, and that's great. A lot of our birds are in a very precarious position. You know, the bald eagles were in a precarious position, they're actually in a better position now, but that's because of what people have done to help them. And we all have our role to play in doing our little piece, just like Dan, just like Jim, to try to make everything a little bit better so that the birds have a better fighting chance.